open up your Unreal, go to Pix Average, go to MetaHumans, and choose a hairstyle of your liking. Check the highest quality and hit download. Once the download is complete, add to your scene. In the content browser, look for MetaHumans, Common, Female Hair, Textures, and look for Hair Cards. Compact, and we are looking for this one, the attribute one, not the touched one. If you look at it, it has multiple channels, all different textures, but we are only going to need the red channel. But how we are going to do that? You can do that in Photoshop, but I'm going to show you a quick free solution. But first, just quickly export this by right-clicking on the texture, Asset Actions, Export. Then save it in your desired folder. Then go to the actual character that you downloaded, look for female or male hair, depending on what you downloaded, go for hair, and find the actual cards mesh. As you can see, there are multiple LODs here, so make sure you will select the LOD 0, which is the highest quality. Then again, right-click, Asset Actions, and Export. We don't need level of detail, everything else looks good, so just hit Export. Open up this site, link will be in the description. Open up the texture that we just saved. Here you can export whatever channel you need, but as I said, we only need the red right now. So let's just select it and hit decompose. Save it down as PNG. We are going to open another website, drop or upload your image that we just saved. Here you can change the resolution if you want to. Go to the black and white. There is shades of gray and black and white only. We want that. Convert it. Go to download. Download image. Call it, for example, Hair Alpha. In Blender, create a new collection. Go to File, Import, Import FBX, and select the hair mesh that we exported from Unreal. You can select these, and you can just delete it, you're not needing it. Select the hair mesh, place it approximately around the head, check the scaling, just in case, it's all one, so it's all okay. Since we used a really great mesh, it's almost a perfect fit from the get-go. But we are going to tweak it in a minute. But first, open another window, go to Shaders, name your material. Then we are going to add two image textures. Click on one of them and open the black and white image that we created. Plug it into the alpha. Now let's see what we have here. Change the color. It's looking quite good. If you are in Eevee, it's going to look like this. But if you are in Cycles, you will most probably going to see some weird stuff happening. That's because Blender needs more light bounces to make this fully transparent. For that, go to Light Path and increase transparency to around 50. And now if you look at it, it looks perfect. Now as I mentioned, the hair almost perfectly aligned with our mesh, but we need some manual tweaking. In edit mode, I'm going to hit proportional editing and I'm going to pull out and move the hair cards just right outside of the character mesh. Try not to stretch it too much, aim for just small adjustments. You can even copy haircut, select one vertex and hit L. This will automatically select the whole plane, then you can just shift D and move it where it's necessary. Okay, I think I'm happy with it, so I'm going to leave it like so. Now let's check the statistic. You can see the trying account here, it can be considered kind of high, but it really depends on what character is that you are currently creating. You can always reuse the triangle account by decimating it. As you can see, the hair is barely changed, but the triangles went down quite good. I'm going to just leave it like this for now. Now drag a new window, set it to shaders, drag yet another window and set it to UV. Now create a new image, I'm going to make it 2K and we are going to call this hair base color. Go and save it. Now in the shaders, look for a color ramp, plug it into the base color. Set the color of your liking. But why is my viewport that slow? Ah, no, it's all good. Can go crazy with this, but I'm just going with some brownish color. Okay, it looks good enough. Now let's turn this color that we just created to an actual texture, because if we want to re-import this back to Unreal, we need an actual texture. For that, make sure your render engine is set to Cycles, go and find Bake, at Bake type select Diffuse. In our case, we don't need Direct nor Indirect, we only need the color. Now select the image node, select your base color image and hit Bake. Now what you will see most probably will be a full black haircut. But the reason that is happening is because the metal is set to 1. You need to make sure before you bake a diffuser that the metallic is set to 0. And now if we are going to hit bake again, you will see the correct color that you set up. Now just save it. We can now unplug this and we can plug in the texture now. Now let's see. Don't forget to change metallic back to 1. I think it's looking pretty decent. Now we want to parent our hair to the armature that we have. We are going to select the hair, then the armature, and hit Ctrl P with empty weights. Now select the rig, select the mesh, go to weight paint, Alt click on the headbone, wireframe, select mix, and we are going to paint the whole hair. We can now go back to object mode. Here the hair is selected, go to the vertex groups, select the head, click on lock, click on this arrow and delete all unlocked vertex groups. Now you can unlock the head back. This was just a little optimization tip. Now it should all work, let's just check. Okay, we are going to quickly export and test out our character. Select your mesh parts, the rig, file, export, export FBX. Select the present that we created in the last episode, name it, hit export. Here we are again in Unreal, we are going to import our character. Select the hair material. In blend mode, select mask. You can select two-sided. And most probably you are going to need to import the alpha texture separately. Open, find your alpha, import it. Drop it in. Connect it to the opacity mask. Then we are going to create a constant. Hold 1 and left click. Plug it into the metallic. Set it to 1. Save it. Close it. I'm going to change the third person character to our own. Then let's hit play. And there you have it.